Is he waking up? I think he's waking up. Oh, well, well, well. Good morning, dear hero. Did you sleep well? Oh, I see you realize this is not your bedroom. And now you realized you were tied up. No, no, don't try to struggle. Even if you could break normal chains, this is special. I forged them myself. It's pure mithril. I know. Who would use something that expensive to make a mail chain? But if it is to catch you, then it is worth it. What do I want? What do I want? Well, I want something that is very easy to get sometimes and really hard to get some other times. Sometimes for what people would change mountains of gold, and at the same time they gave it without asking anything in return. Something that can be heavier than mercury and at the same time floats on thin air. Is very painful and also more pleasurable than food, drugs or sex. What I want is love. Your love, to be more precise. But I don't only want your love. I want your devotion. I want your passion. I want your lust. I want your softness and your dominance. I want to drive you crazy for me. And I want you not for one night or one day or one year. I want you to rest your head on my shoulder and hold my hand on the day of your death. I want to make you mine forever, for the rest of your mortal life and even after that. What are you saying? But, dear hero, you do know me. You don't remember me. Oh, I'm sure you remember our last encounter. It's just that you don't recognize me. Well, you see, the last time you saw me, I looked a little more like this. So now you remember. But I don't need to use that form now. Yes, that dragon. The one you supposedly slayed like 2 months ago. The one for whose death the king paid you enough gold to keep you fed for at least 5 years. You celebrated my death. You and all your friends laughing, drinking, dancing and enjoying yourself to the thought of me being dead? Yes! You stabbed me 7 times! With a long sword and live while I was bleeding out, but I didn't die. Yes, I didn't breathe. And yes, even my heart stopped. But you see, reptile metabolism is very different from yours, you primitive monkeys, some snakes, crocs. And yes, dragons are able to lower their heart rate when they need to. My species can do it so well that our heart gives 1 beat per minute when we are at our worst times. like without food for a couple of years, in low oxygen levels, and having lost more than half of our blood. Why do I want you to love me? Are you that dense, dear Hero? It's because I love you. I fell in love with you. Why do you ask? Well, it is for a couple of reasons, but mostly is because you almost killed me. Listen, before meeting you, I was the strongest being I could think of. I was born in the mountains where we fought, in the middle of the ice. My mother, she was kind of old when I hatched. Well, me and my siblings, we were our last children. You see, for dragons, power is very important. So we make our children fight among themselves and raise the stronger. The rest have to leave or be killed. I hate my siblings and was raised by my mother. No, it wasn't traumatic. I was like weeks old. I don't remember any of that. Well, at age 15, I had already surpassed my own mother's strength. And by age 20, I had defeated not only other dragons that tried to take possession of my territory, but also whole armies of humans. It was peaceful. I considered myself to be basically a goddess and honestly thought that I was going to live the rest of my life without knowing defeat or even a worthy opponent. It was fine. An easy life with no struggle. Just eating whichever lowly creature that approached my cave, sheep, deer, humans, elves, or even demons. Nothing implied effort. Just fly to them, grab their small bodies, and bite off their heads. Brutal? Brutal is the way you try to kill. I give my prey the quickest death possible. The point is, when you arrived, I was like, okay, whatever. Just bite you and it is over. Then you hit me with your shield and I feel it. And it was painful. Not really painful, but it was something. After that, you grabbed your sword and pointed at me. And I knew that if I attacked you frontally, you would be able to stab me. So I used my fire and you just endured it and walked through it. It was kind of cool. Then you tried to cut my neck. I had to dodge your attack and jump backwards. I was about to use my fire again and I felt horrible thing. Something I had forgotten about. Pain. You stabbed me in between my ribs. Nothing too deep, but you were a human. A mere, puny, significant human. A being that weighs as much as 20th of myself. But you didn't stop there. I used my magic to harden my scales. Your sword didn't cut me anymore. But I felt every single of your strikes like if you were Hephaestus himself forging weapons. At some point, I decided to just fly and attack you from the sky. You threw your sword. I didn't know it was possible. You pierced my left wing. It was more painful than any other wound. I fell to the ground and attacked you with fire again and again and again, and all the times you just ran through it and stabbed me in my neck and ribs. The last thing I remember is that you were looking down onto my... You took off your helmet and stabbed me in my chest. It almost pierced my heart. That moment I felt fear. For the first time in my life, I felt fear. I thought I was going to die and I felt fear of it. And also, humiliation. A burning feeling of total humiliation. Like melted steel poured inside my veins. I fainted. You left. When I woke up, after like a week, crows were feeding on my wounds. And I didn't move. I didn't move for like 10 minutes. Afraid of you being near. Afraid that you were there to hand the job, but you weren't. After that, I tried to get up. I couldn't. I was too weak to even get on my own feet. I looked at myself, covered in dried blood, covered in wounds. I cried. I cried. Humiliated, defeated, broken, and crying. It took me at least 1 month to recover physically. And well, the only thing on my mind all this time was your face. Looking down at me, looking into my eyes with a cold gaze as you tortured me, as you destroyed my defenseless body. You see now?
Do you comprehend why I want you to be mine?
No, not to torture you. Not only for torturing you, at least. I want the human that defeated me. The strongest creature I have ever seen as my mate. I want my descendants to be born out of your seed. I want to be honed and defiled only by the one creature I could not kill. The one creature I could not submit to me in battle. The one creature that stands over me in the scale of power. I want you to make me yours. And I want to make you mine. I want you to love me, to admire me, to change the cold glance that keeps haunting me in my dreams into an expression of love and desire. That's why I take on this form, a human form. That's why I asked an elder witch to help me put you to sleep, and why I forced these chains out of the same armor you were wearing during our battle. You are going to leave her with me for the rest of your life. And if you love me and admire me, if you warm up to me, you and I will become the perfect couple. I will maintain this human form and let you call me your wife. And you will make me the mother of the most glorious offspring any dragon would be jealous of. Or you will refuse to accept my love and you will become my toy. And I will have endless hours of fun torturing you day and night for the rest of your life. So tell me, will you be mine?
Hey guys, thank you for listening. If you like the content, please hit on the like button. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel, please subscribe to the channel. And also check out my other videos on your screen. As always, be kind, love yourself, believe in yourself, and I love you all. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.